Hi, I'm Susie McKee of Live Well Fit, and I had some people ask me about how to open up their hips after running or walking. So I'm going to give you three or four quick tips on how to open up your hips. If you've been sitting at your office desk or riding in a car or running, our IT bands get really tight. And so what I want to do is just take you through a couple of basic stretches. Yoga is also wonderful. I teach a class called Restore Yoga where I do a lot of hip opening. So what you want to do is you want to get some kind of warm-up. I'm going to skip the warm-up just to get right to the stretch. But you do want to do some kind of forward flexion in your hip and mobilize your hips quite a bit. When you do come down to a runner's lunge, keep your knee behind your heel. So in other words, you don't want to be here. You want to keep that spine in neutral. Keep your knee behind your heel and then slowly lower that knee to the ground. You want most of your weight into your front knee. And then lift up that chin so your whole posterior chain is firing. You're going to open up that hip flexor. One thing people don't do is they don't squeeze their glute of their opposite hip or the same hip. And if you do engage that muscle, that'll allow that hip to stretch. So you want to sink into that and then gently back up and then slide this leg forward. So you want to keep that chest nice and extended. And then you want to kind of rock and play with the hip motion, rolling back and forth. So you'll notice I'm keeping my spine really straight, and I'm just kind of rotating my hips back and forth, letting my adductor and my hamstring stretch. Now from here, that front leg's going to walk in front of your opposite hip. So my right foot is in line with my left hip, and then I'm going to gently lower that down. So coming onto a frontal view, what you might have is you might wind up being about right here, and that's real normal. You're going to be really tight. But as you get more and more flexible, that knee will come closer to the ground. You don't want to roll over to the hip. You want to walk that bottom knee under, and then you want to gently ease down. So once you can turn that back knee under and rotate your chest, really press that chest and lift it up. But a deeper stretch is going to be with the knee and the ankle are nice and even. And then you want to try to continue to walk that knee under. Now, it's not going to happen overnight, so this needs to be a daily thing. So once that knee can come under, then you've got another option to reach that chest out and keep that spine extended. And so then the next step would be to come all the way down and release. Once you stay here for three or four deep breaths, take your opposite hand, reach on the outside of that knee, take this hand to the outside, lift your rib cage up, and then slide that hand out over that knee. You will feel that wonderful rotation in that hip. And extend. And then to stretch that hip on the outside, lift up gently, wrap this leg around, place this foot on the outside where that ankle is just hanging out. Your knee may be right here, perfectly fine. You want to gently work that knee down with the glute and the chest lifting up, and then you eventually want to have that knee pressed down. When you can get that knee as low as possible, again, press through that chest and let that hip release. So you want to do that on both sides, guys, otherwise you walk funny, right? So start in that open hip, and then bring the chest down, and then there's several other things we can do in Restore Yoga. So I hope your hips are open up today. You guys have a wonderful day, and come see me at Live Well Fit.